Let's talk about ecstasy. Ecstasy was synthesized back in 1912 by Merck Pharmaceuticals for helping you clot your blood. But it turns out it didn't really work very well as a blood clotter for people hemorrhaging and so on. And it kind of was on the shelf, and then someone dusted it off in the 1950s and discovered it had these empathogenic effects, made you feel more connected to people. It made you feel a sense of communion with other people. And its name, frankly, back in those days was empathy. That got changed to, you know, Molly and ecstasy and so on. And it, I think, it's probably more famous as a party drug in the rave culture, but where it's really caught on is in post-traumatic stress disorder. Now, that's not the only disorder, but that's the one I would say is the lead disorder. And there's been a lot of media coverage of this the last, I would say, 12 to 36 months, some of the studies that are starting to appear in some very high quality journals. Now, one of the questions asked you about the mechanism of action, it does affect catecholamines in the sense that it's a pseudo substrate for the 5-HT2, the 5-HT transporter, the serotonin transporter. What it also does is it goes inside the presynaptic neuron. In fact, it even inhibits VMAT, and it results in a release of serotonin. So what you get is you get this serotonin reuptake blockade, but you also get a release of serotonin. But it doesn't just stop there. It also has effects on prolactin. It has effects on cortisol, and it increases your oxytocin, the attachment hormone. And the oxytocin decreases the activity in the amygdala. Most of you were right on that particular question. So why is it being developed in PTSD? What's the rationale? Well, the rationale is it seems to facilitate fear extinction, as well as memory reconsolidation. So when you and I have a memory, an event, we have a memory, we file it, we consolidate it, and then we retrieve it for later, and then we reconsolidate our memories. And for people who have PTSD, there's a reason why we want to extinguish the fear response. There's also a reason why we want to take those memories and maybe modify them a little bit and then reconsolidate them so that you're not held ransom to these traumas, these memories that you've had. And there's a molecular story, there's a circuit story, and there's a blood flow story showing that MDMA is targeting different aspects of the memory retrieval and reconsolidation process, facilitating aspects of fear extinction. So you don't have the same reaction. So obviously the trauma still occurred. You haven't forgotten of the trauma, but you don't have the same fear reaction to it. Moreover, you don't in fact have the same degree of autonomic activity. You don't have the same multi-section brain activity to this traumatic experience. And it's an extremely interesting finding, and I would say highly replicated in this area. So this gives you a bit more detail, perhaps more than we actually need on early morning. But the point is, it's not just engaging aspects of serotonin, but it's also aspects of other catecholamines, the alpha-2 system, hormonal systems, and key brain structures facilitating fear extinction and memory reconsolidation. This is a study that was published a few months back where the investigators gave people with PTSD between 120 and 180 milligrams of ecstasy along with a trauma-focused psychotherapy and showed significant reduction and remission rates extraordinarily high in people who had PTSD, as evidenced by changes on the PTSD scale. And that was made a lot of headlines. All the news outlets covered that. And that was obviously a very promising study that needs to be replicated, that needs to be reproduced. Everything has side effects. Placebo has side effects. And I'm not going to go through all of this, but here are some of the well-known concerns around abuse and diversion. Many of us have seen lots of people abuse this particular drug in our clinical practice, and you know some of the psychiatric and physical consequences of that. I've seen many patients who complain of Blue Monday and very suicidal Black Tuesdays. This is the crash early in the week after you've been using this drug all weekend. And so I think we are reminded, we're reminded yet again, that these drugs have psychoactive effects. These drugs will have to be developed and have to be researched with the utmost of caution and care as it relates to the safety of these products, because there are very serious tolerability and safety concerns.